Hi, welcome to Isom Academy. Let's begin with all you need to know about ammonia. Ammonia is a colorless gas at room temperature with a very pungent, irritating smell detectable at 25 ppm, consisting of one nitrogen atom bonded to three hydrogen atoms. It is toxic, highly reactive, corrosive, alkaline gas that dissolves easily in water to form ammonium hydroxide. Ammonia gas is lighter than air. However, in presence of moisture, it reacts to form vapors of the liquefied anhydrous ammonia gas. These vapors are heavier than air and may spread along the ground into low-lying areas with poor ventilation, where there is a risk of exposure. Ammonia is released from decaying organic matter, including plants, animals, animal waste, and fertilizer use. Largest source of ammonia is agriculture, including emissions from fertilizer application and livestock waste. Other sources of ammonia include composting of organic matter, biomass burning, livestock management, vehicular emissions, landfills, and sewage treatment plants. Industrial emissions include fertilizer manufacturing, coke manufacture, pharmaceutical and cleaning products, and refrigeration methods. It remains in the atmosphere for a day or less before either getting deposited back onto terrestrial surfaces by dry deposition or being converted to ammonium particulate matter through reaction with atmospheric acids, hydrogen sulfuric acid, and HNO3. These particles can travel to 100 to 1000 kilometers, resulting in long-range transport of reactive nitrogen. Also, deposition of ammonia emissions back to the landscape contributes to the eutrophication of soil and surface water, which has a negative impact on plant and animal species. Ammonia immediately reacts with available moisture in the skin, eyes, oral cavity, and respiratory tract to form the very caustic ammonium hydroxide. Low-level exposures can cause coughing as well as irritation to eyes, nose, throat, and respiratory tract. Exposure to high levels can cause airway destruction, resulting in respiratory distress or failure, and can also lead to death. Prolonged exposure of the ammonia can quickly deaden a person's sense of smell, making the odor of ammonia an unreliable indicator of its presence. Hence, other means such as use of ammonia monitors is a viable solution to provide adequate warning of hazardous exposure. Different working principles from ammonia monitoring in the ambient environment are chemiluminescence, semiconductor, and electrochemistry. At OISOM, we measure ammonia on principle of electrochemical sensing. It operates based on diffusion of ammonia molecules into the sensor, which results in the production of an electrical signal proportional to the ammonia concentration. OISOM's OdorSense is the real-time odor emission tracking solution. It continuously detects, measures, and monitors the odorful gaseous contaminants including ammonia, hydrogen sulfide, sulfur dioxide, methyl mercaptan, TVOCs, methane, and formaldehyde, and also weather parameters like temperature, humidity, wind speed, and wind direction. Now, with the help of meteorological data, OdorSense can trace the odorant dispersion plume incited by conditions like wind speed and wind direction. OdorSense is a proactive approach to measure real-time odor emissions. This makes it an ideal choice for landfill sites, wastewater treatment facilities, paper pulp industries, and soil treatment plants. Real-time monitoring of ammonia levels helps in calculating air quality index to deliver health advisories as well as formulating an action plan to meet standards. With this, I hope you now know all about ammonia. For any questions or suggestions, please contact us. Thank you and happy learning.